Hello friends, I'm Ms. Marks and you are watching Math for Juniors. I wonder where Snail is, What happened to you, Snail?
I was looking for my socks and banged my head very badly on a table.
But do you keep your socks under the table?
No, I was just searching for it. I actually keep it anywhere I feel like.
That's not a good habit, Snail. You must keep your things at the proper positions. That helps you locate them easily when you need them. In fact, in this module, we'll study how to locate points in a coordinate plane.
Will that help me find my socks?
Not really, but it will help you locate points and understand a lot of things. So, let's enter the virtual world. Let's begin the module on Introduction to Coordinate System with this interesting illustration. It's movie time for a little boy and his friends. Tickets were hard to get on a weekend, but the little boy has somehow managed. It's so dark inside, boy needs help to locate his seat. Attendant helped him to locate his seat. Attendant's skill set gets the boy thinking. Is there any specific approach to locate the exact location of the seat in such a huge auditorium? Question is an inquisitive one. So let's gain insight on this approach in this module on coordinate systems, where we study what a coordinate plane is and what are coordinates of a point, and to plot a point on a coordinate plane. Let's consider this. Today is big day. It's little boy's birthday. So he and his mom are decorating the room for the birthday party. Wind chime on the window looks nice. The boy is unsure of the most appropriate position of the flower vase. Mom knows the best. The boy must remember the exact position of the vase so that next time onwards he knows where to keep it just right. Let's see how his mom fixed the vase on the table. The boy recalls. The vase must be in upper half of the table or near the left edge or close to the left upper corner. But none of these statements actually fix the position of the vase. A smart way could be measuring its distance from the left edge, say 45 centimeters. But then the vase could be kept all along the width. Thus, to fix the position of vase, its distance either from bottom or top edge is required. Say it's 60 centimeters. So the vase is kept at 45 centimeters from left edge and 60 centimeters from the bottom edge. So the position of the vase is the point 45-60. Locating a point on the number line requires one parameter. However, locating a point in a plane needs two parameters. For this, two number lines perpendicular to each other intersecting at zero came. The point of intersection is the origin. The horizontal line is called x-axis and the vertical line is called y-axis. The whole plane including the axis is called the coordinate plane or xy plane. Position of a point on the plane is given by the ordered pair xy, where x coordinate is the distance of the point from y-axis and y coordinate is its distance from x axis. So did you understand that, Snail?
Oh yes!
Okay, now let me ask you a question. Do you know about the concept of latitude and longitude?
Yes, Ms. Marks. I have studied it in my geography class. Are we going to study that now?
No, Snail. You know, math can be applied to geography as well.
How?
The coordinates of Delhi are 28° 35' north and 77° 12' east. With this latitude and longitude, you can easily locate Delhi on a globe.
Oh, I never thought mathematical results can be even applied to geography as well.
There are a lot more facts that you can't even think. Anyways, it's now time to enter the world of math again to learn more about coordinate system. Let's locate the point 3, 4 in the coordinate plane. Count 3 units to the right on the x-axis. Then count up 4 units parallel to the y-axis. Place the dot. Point A is the required position of the point. The order of coordinates is very important since the point 3, 4 and 4, 3 represent two different positions on the coordinate plane. It's time to answer the question raised in the beginning of module. Now let's see how the boy quickly finds his seat with the help of the attendant. Well, boy's seat number was D15. The seats of the cinema halls are arranged in rows from A to Z. And each row has seats starting from 1 to 20. Thus, seat D15 would be 15th seat of 4th row. So, Snail, did you understand that? Snail?
Yes, Ms.Marks.
Why do you keep getting lost?
Oh, Ms.Marks, I am trying to find Delhi according to the coordinates you told.
Oh my god, Snail, you're absolutely correct this time. By the way, we are getting late, as it's time to enter the virtual world. Mirror image of a plane figure can be obtained by applying the coordinate geometry. For example, in order to draw the mirror image of this triangular pendant, first, let's take its replica on the graph sheet. Now, indicate the coordinates of the three vertices. Find the reflection of each of these three points across y-axis, keeping the y-coordinate as it is and negating the x-coordinate. The three reflected vertices are A', B' and C'. Join these points to get the reflected image of pendant. Similarly, we can obtain a mirror image across x-axis by negating the y-coordinate and keeping x-coordinate as it is.
This is very interesting, Ms.Marks. I'm curious to learn more.
That should not be a problem, Snail, because I'm always curious to teach more.
That makes me realize, Ms.Marks, that it's time for some offbeat knowledge.
You're right, Snail. So let's check out our Do You Know segment. Do you know that we can draw two-dimensional figures such as square, rectangle, etc. on a XY plane? Whereas a three-dimensional object such as cube would require Z-axis as well, which means another plane, making it a bit difficult.
Well, Ms. Marks, I have observed that a square is drawn by joining line segments, whereas a cube is made by joining squares. Is there any pattern in this?
Yes, there is, Snail. According to the dimensional analogy, a 2D figure is formed by joining one-dimensional figures, a 3D object by 2D surfaces, and one may also infer that a four-dimensional cube known as tesseract is formed by three-dimensional objects.
Oh, that's amazing!
And now it's time for a quick memory jog. So let's hit the recap button and revise all that we have learned in this episode. In this module, we have learned the following: to locate the position of an object or a point, we require two perpendicular number lines. One of them is horizontal and the other is vertical. The horizontal line is called x-axis and vertical line is called y-axis. The distance of a point from y-axis is called its x-coordinate and the distance of a point from x-axis is called its y-coordinate. To reflect a point across axis, keep the respective coordinate as it is and negate the other coordinate.
So friends, with this we come to the end of another interesting episode of Math for Juniors.
You stole my line, Snail. Snail.
Oh, Ms.Marks, I thought I will quickly say bye and will go and apply my knowledge of coordinates to find my socks.
That sounds a little weird. Yet as you wish, Snail, huh? So kids, we'll see you again very soon. Till then, goodbye.